It's time now for Police on the Scene with a Crime Prevention Lean. With your host, police officer and national crime prevention professional, J.D. Dine.
Hey, welcome to Police on the Scene. This is Officer J.D. Dine. I am with a couple of friends today. I first have Battalion Chief John Madak of the North Shore Fire Department and also Sparky the Fire Dog. How are you doing, John?
Good, great.
Good. Hey, in a second, I just want you, there's a lot of noise here in the background. We have the state championship for the Fireman's Challenge for high school kids. And John, give me a little bit of background on what this competition's all about.
So various fire departments throughout the state have explorer posts.
Okay.
The explorer posts, the kids are eligible to start at 13 years of age and go right on through high school. Now this competition that you're seeing here is mirroring a national firefighter competition sponsored by Paul Davis Restoration. Firefighter Jeremy Belke with the North Shore Fire Department has been working for the past 10 years with getting this all set up. There's awards given out, and each year we're getting bigger and bigger. I think bringing it to this atmosphere has added a whole new experience.
Yeah, I was going to say, it brings another level, and we're laughing because we've got people going in front. We had McGruff, the crime dog, sneaking up and back. This place is absolutely chaotic, and what we're getting to in the competition right now is you're going to be able to hear some cheering, because what they do, John, is they go up a scaffold, three levels, come down, they carry hose, and then they body drag. How much does that body weigh?
The body's 185 pounds.
185 pounds?
Yeah, they're dragging it 100 feet after they've pulled hose over 100 feet.
Oh,
so it's a pretty physical contest.
Yeah, and I saw them this morning, and they're just completely gassed at the end. And you hear them really cheering them on here, and I'm hoping, because it takes between 2 and 3 minutes, and they should be coming up here really quick. So this is this the first year it's been at Safety Day?
Well, we had it last year, but we had it indoors. This is the first time that we were able to secure a tower to actually do it outside. And as you can see, it just adds so much to the event. We've got barricades everywhere. A lot of cheering, like you said. It's great.
Yeah, it's awesome. And yours truly might get on the mic here in a little bit. I like to fire them up over there. Yep. It's really warm out here. I mean, it's going to be over 80, and you got to give these kids a lot of credit. And they do a lot of training for it, don't they, John?
Absolutely. These kids all year round are doing training. And like you said, you're talking, they're wearing gear, so that's going to add 100 pounds. Everything they do is just physically demanding. So if you're not prepared, you'll be in trouble.
How many kids do you think is in this competition?
I think we have around 70 competitors and around 12 different fire departments.
Unbelievable. 70 competitors, 12 different fire departments. I know they came as far north as Wausau, Wisconsin. Was that
correct? Yeah, Wausau. I think we have Menasha. We have some competitors from Illinois.
Wow. Unbelievable. Good, good. All right. So if your son or daughter's interested in fire safety or getting involved in Explorer Post, who should they contact?
I would go to your local fire department and ask if they have anything available. They should be, if they don't have anything available at their department, they should be able to point you in the right direction to someone who has the program.
Yeah, and I know, I mean, there's a lot of volunteer fire departments. Don't worry about your department not being big enough. Like John just said, they'll guide you in the right direction. It's a close-knit group. Doesn't matter what state you're in, they have explorer posts all over. With that said, I am Officer J.D. Dine with Police on the Scene, and me... we've got our battalion chief, John Madak, and Sparky, the fire dog. We're all 10-8.